Professor Bleckerman. This short video is about the process that happens after you file an application to the Master of Science in Financial Engineering program at NYU Tandon. Everything that happens until the application is complete is between you and the Department of Graduate Admissions here at NYU Tandon. Once the graduate admissions people tell us that an application is complete, they surrender it to us, we begin to look at it, and what follows in this presentation are the things that we look for and what we find important to make sure that we admit people who can be successful financial engineers. So what do? We look at, fundamentally, five categories of different things. We look at your grades as an undergraduate student. We look at how well you know the material, the prerequisite material that we need you to know to begin studying with us. We look at your GRE scores. We look to see if you have any job experience. We look at your TOEFL or IELTS score if you are an international student under some circumstances, which I will try to explain in a minute or two. When we look at your undergraduate grades, what do we see? What do we look for? We look for high grades overall. The average GPA of a student that we accept from a United States university or college is about 3.75. We look at the grades that you get in specific courses in mathematics and computer sciences. Now, if you have a GPA that's not 3.75, but you're straight A in math and computer science, that's a good thing. If you have a 3.8 or a 3.9, but you have grades of C in math, that's not a good thing. We look for both strength overall and strength in areas that prepare you to study financial engineering. And we, of course, look at the reputation of the college or university that you went to as an undergraduate. What prerequisites do we specifically look for? Well, we look to make sure that all of your prerequisite material was done at an accredited institution. Lots of times we get the question, hey, I don't know computer programming, can I learn it on edX or Coursera? And the answer is, yeah, learning computer programming on edX or Coursera is a great thing, but we need to know that you really know this, and edX and Coursera are not graded platforms where we can get a real good feeling that you're good at that stuff. So we need everything to come from an accredited institution. We need to look at calculus through multivariable calculus. Some places call it Calc 3, some places call it multivariable calc. It depends where you went to school. We look at your programming grades. We look at grades in courses called linear algebra, usually, sometimes matrix algebra. We look at courses that you've taken in applied probability theory, sometimes called stochastic processes. This is very important. And we look for grades that you've earned in courses in statistics and applied statistics, specifically not business statistics, but statistics from a statistics department or statistics from a mathematics department or an engineering department. Now, these things are all prerequisites. If you don't have all of these things on your transcript when you apply, we will not admit you. So what do? You can go to a local college after graduation and you can fill in the gaps that you have in your background, and that'll be just fine. But we do not conditionally accept students who have these things missing, assuming that they will fill them in when they get here. When you arrive here, this stuff here, all of it, has to be as easy for you as taking out your phone and sending a text message, because these are the tools that we use to do financial engineering. We look at your GRE scores. The accepted students for the class of 2017 had an average GRE score of 168.9 on the quant side and 155 on the verbal side. If your score on the quant side is under 160, we will see only a summary of your application and it will be automatically rejected. So 160 is the hard floor for quant GRE test scores. We want to have a diverse student body. We want to have students from many walks of life, from many different places. And sometimes what we will do to achieve that is we'll take this 160 minimum GRE quant score, and from places where we get a lot of applications, we will raise that minimum above 160. So there'll be places where it'll just be harder to get in from, and that's the way it is when we have places on the in the world or people of certain backgrounds that are rarities and can add value by providing unique experiences and perspectives in our classrooms. Those people, the floor will be closer to 160. On the verbal side, the floor is 146. Below that, we won't look. If you have job experience or research experience, and if it is relevant to the world that we live in here in financial engineering, we absolutely will weigh that when we decide whether or not to grant admission. If you don't have job experience or research experience, then you are pretty similar to about 70% of our incoming students. About 70% of our students come to us directly from undergraduate programs, and the other 30% of our students have some work experience or research experience. Okay, TOEFL scores, or alternatively, IELTS scores. If you're an international applicant and you went to college in a place where English is not the language of government, then our graduate admissions team will require you to take a TOEFL exam or an IELTS exam. Right now, those exams are simply like light switches. If you score above, at or above 90 on a TOEFL or at or above 7 on the IELTS, your application can proceed. If you do not, your application is denied. There is thought in the near future of raising these thresholds from 90 on the TOEFL and 7 on the IELTS and of doing more compensatory modeling with them, but right now they're absolute, 90 and above or 7 and above. If you have questions about the application process and our decision making about applications, there are three different ways to get your question answered. Each way is appropriate to a different kind of question. If you have a question about the process of filing an application, what to submit, when to submit it, letters of recommendation, test scores, the application itself, supporting material, statement of purpose, resume, all of those things, along with questions about where is the application in process, do you have everything, all of those questions go to engineering.gradinfo@nyu.edu. If you have questions about the graduation requirements of our program, the curriculum of our program, or if you have questions about a particular course in our program as a requirement or as an elective, the email address for that is engineering.fre. That's our department, Finance and Risk Engineering. engineering.fre@nyu.edu. And if you have questions about this presentation, I'd be more than happy to answer them. My email address is bsb279@nyu.edu. If you send the email message to the wrong place, it will eventually find its way to the right place, but it will delay you getting an answer. So try to focus on what kind of question you have and the right place to send it. I thank you for your time. I look forward to seeing your application and answering your questions.